Wow, it seems ages since I've been in front of the camera. Hopefully you've been watching the journey of my learners within the workshop and on site as my adults work towards their domestic installer qualification, and my learners are now finishing off either a level 1, level 2 or level 3 diploma. The video I'm putting together today is to help my new learners coming in from September. We're going to look at the basic 10 tools that Tresham College give each of our learners when they're working within the workshop. I have two toolboxes here, both with 10 tools in, and we're going to look closer at what they physically look like, and then we're going to name those tools as well. We're not fortunate enough to have physically the same looking tools in each box, so we're going to have to be very careful to identify our tools. For example, being both of these tools here, which we call a medium flat tip screwdriver or possibly electrician screwdriver, are exactly the same named for us within our toolbox, but obviously physically look different. So we're going to look at two of the toolboxes that we've got here at Tresham, and we're going to name the tools identically in both, but physically look at the differences between them. We're going to bring the camera in closer in order to do so. Let's do that in the next part of the presentation. So I've emptied from the two toolboxes, one this side and one this side, three screwdrivers, and in the case here, a Bradawl on each end. So we're going to need to identify and name these tools. As we just said a moment ago, that we've got this screwdriver here with a flat head on it, physically don't look the same, and possibly even the width of the actual flat on the screwdriver is not identical. However, at a poor old college like we are, this will be the screwdriver that we're going to use and name as our electrician screwdriver or medium flat tip. So we should have one of these in each of our toolboxes. This is a medium flat tip screwdriver. Not quite the same physically, but they are the medium flat tip that you will find in your toolbox. Next screwdriver out in both cases here. Again, we can see they're not physically the same. The tip on this one is slightly smaller than the tip on this one. And we're not going to describe it by the size of these tips because they're all obviously slightly different. We're going to describe this tool as our terminal screwdriver. We can see that it is smaller than our electrician screwdriver, and that is our terminal screwdriver. Actual applications of these tools will be talked about in the classroom and workshop. At the moment, it's just identifying them. So we have a terminal screwdriver, the smallest flat-headed screwdriver in your box. Next screwdriver out. Again, we can see they physically look different. It's the head style again we're describing. In this case, these are posi drive screwdrivers. We're not going to talk about it in a number for the posi. We're just going to call that a posi drive screwdriver for those. And then finally, not a screwdriver, a tool for starting holes, and those are Bradawls. So we can see again, slightly different looking tools, but actually the ends are what we're looking at in order, and the width and length of, to describe that as a Bradawl for starting holes. So I've got two tools out now from each of the boxes. In this case, I've got a pair of pliers from each box. Again, not exactly physically the same size or even the same style, but we're looking at them to be pliers. We've got a cutting action here and the ability to grip on the ends. So both of those will be named pliers within our toolkits. And then as we move out to the outside, we've got these, again, physically not look the same as in color wise, but we have got the same sort of action and motion. We've got the ability to cut on both of these, and these are side cutters. So we've got, in toolboxes, we'll have pliers and we will have side cutters within the 10 tools within a Tresham toolbox. Each of our toolboxes will also have a hammer in them. So we've got hammers here, and these are both claw hammers. So we get a hammer in each of the toolboxes. First tool that's actually the same physically looking within the toolboxes, we've got our junior hacksaw. So another one of our 10 tools is a junior hacksaw. Tape measures, so they should be approximately 5 meters for all of them, but not necessarily are. So we always look for the IMEC one. They're the best tape measures we've got within our toolboxes. So we've got a 5 meter tape measure in both cases. Again, physically don't look the same by color, but they are our 5 meter tape measures. And then our knives. So here we have a fixed blade knife here, and we've got another fixed blade knife here. This time it has a cover on it. Again, physically don't look the same, but we have a knife within our 10 tools of our Tresham toolbox. So that's just a quick look at the 10 tools that Tresham College give their learners during their practical sessions. We're gonna need to remember and name those very early on in September when you come to me. However, all the learners I interviewed had either a PlayStation or an Xbox. When I got out a Tresham toolbox and pulled out some of those tools, all of those learners struggled or couldn't name any of those tools. And as I said at interview, time to sell your Xbox and buy yourself a toolbox. Joking aside, let's run through those 10 tools once more. Medium flat tip or electrician's screwdriver within the Tresham toolbox. A posi drive screwdriver. A terminal screwdriver. And a Bradawl for starting or making holes. Hammer, in this case a claw hammer within our toolbox. A 5 meter tape measure. A junior hacksaw. Side cutters. A pair of pliers. And a fixed blade knife are all tools found within a Tresham toolbox. I hope this video has been some help.